Hey y'all, it's Danny. Welcome to our winch wiring video. Our winch is already mounted up on this machine, so if you need to see how to do that, there'll be a link in the description to part one where we mounted it up. Now we're going to get straight into the wiring. And we'll also be wiring up this fancy Can-Am winch in, winch out switch, so if that's all you need to see, go ahead and fast forward to the end of the video where we'll be getting to that. Hopefully the video will be a little more helpful for anyone with any machine. Anyway, let's get started. So when you open your winch box, you'll notice a lot of different wires and parts. To keep it simple, I like to start with the black box called the solenoid and the four big wires that attach to it. The poles are color labeled, so attaching the four big wires is pretty easy. The red and the black will go from the solenoid to our battery, and the blue and yellow to our winch. Also, a little caveat for the red wire going to the battery is the circuit breaker is going to go on the end right next to the battery. With the four big wires attached, we mounted our solenoid to a safe area on the machine by drilling two small holes and securing it with the provided hardware. We have our yellow and blue wires running towards our winch, and we're about to run the red and black to the battery. So to remove the dash, there's two pop rivets on each side and two Torx 25 bolts on the top. And once we pop this out, we'll be able to feed our wires up from the solenoid to the battery and also eventually to our switch. I like to use electrical tape to wrap the circuit breaker on the red wire just so it doesn't short out when we tuck it in the dash. I know all you guys out there with Can-Ams love those sweet winch switches that plug right into the factory switchboard, so let's take a quick look at how to wire those up. So to get started, we're going to cut the wire running to the remote plug and expose the red, black, brown, and blue wires that are underneath. Then we're going to attach connectors to each wire by splicing away a short amount of the insulation and crimping on connectors. After crimping the wire, give it a little tug to make sure the connection's tight. Now that all four wires have connectors on them, we can make sure to run them through the dash before we connect them to our switch. Anyway, the order is black, brown, red, and blue on the right side of the back of the switch. The switch came with this little adapter to allow two connections for the red wire. Order goes black, brown, red, blue. Since we'll be using an aftermarket switch on the Commander, let's take a look at this Razor 900 and kind of talk about what the wiring would look like if you wanted to use the original switches that came with your winch. Now to mount the winch remote plug, we're going to pick a spot in the dash and use our step-up drill bit. This plug is already mounted on this machine, but I wanted to mention to work very carefully and slowly when using a step-up drill bit on plastic because it's really easy to make the holes too big, and I can tell you that from experience. To mount the rocker switch, we're just going to look around for a convenient bar and bolt it on. Now you're going to notice a red wire coming from the rocker switch wiring. We need to connect this red wire to a wire on the machine that gets power when the ignition is on. The most convenient wire to tap is usually going to be the power wire running into the back of our cigarette lighter. So the easiest way to tap into wires that I found is with these wire tapping connectors I found on Amazon. You just crimp the male connector onto your red wire, snap the female side around the wire you want to tap into, and just plug it in. In this case, it's an orange and white wire. That's pretty much my best effort at a winch wiring video. If you found it helpful, give us a like. But if the video wasn't helpful or is unclear, I missed something, I didn't show you what you needed to know, please leave me a comment in the section below so I can make these videos better for you. If you missed part one on winch mounting, there'll be a link in the description, and we'll see y'all on the trails.